Very, very good morning, my dear. Welcome you all in this lesson. Today I'll talk that every differentiable function is continuous. Function is continuous. We have discussed about the continuity, we have discussed about the differentiability also, and after that we have discussed and solved the problems of one exercise also, 5.1 and 5.2. Now tell me, the function is y is equal to f of x is a function, and now this function is continuous. That means the graph drawn is without break. There is no breaking in this graph of this function y is equal to f of x. Right? It means continuous. Differentiable means what? At one point, I think when I was discussing the geometrical meaning of the differentiation d over dx, by that time I have discussed, that means I can draw the tangent at this point, at this point, or at this point, that is differentiable, right? Now the theorem says that every differentiable function is continuous, every differentiable function is continuous, but the converse is not true, right? So now first I will prove the first part. Now see, one function y is equal to f of x is differentiable. It means what? Y is equal to f of x, or any function f of x, is differentiable. Differentiable at x is equal to c. What do you mean by this? It means what? Y is equal to f of x is differentiable at x is equal to c. It means limit f of x tends to c is equal to limit f of c x tends to c. Or simply I can write f of c. Yes, sir. That I have checked with this LSDN RST. That means limit of f of x extends to c is equal to f of c. That means the differentiable function y is equal to f of x is differentiable at is equal to c. That means this we have to prove. Yes, if limit of f of x extends to c is equal to limit of f of x extends to c or f of c, then we say that the function is differentiable as well as continuous also, right? Now let us go for the proof of this. One more thing that I taught you, that if a function is differentiable at x is equal to a, that means if I ask you find out the value of f dash of a, then what do you write? Limit h tends to 0 f of a plus h minus f of a upon a plus h minus a. Here a plus h minus a, if I cancel a and a, I'll get simply a over here also. That also we know. Or I have used this f dash of c is equal to limit h tends to 0 f of c plus h minus f of c upon c plus h minus c, or simply h. This is the definition of the differentiability which we have learned. Yes, sir. Is there any problem? Using the same concept, this can be also written as like this. Now, for the proof of this, I can say let a function y is equal to f of x is differentiable at x is equal to c. When it is differentiable at x is equal to c, we have f dash of c. F dash of c is equal to limit x tends to c f of x minus f of c upon x minus c. This part we have, right? F dash of c is equal to limit x tends to c f of x minus f of c upon x minus c. That's simple, the concept of the differentiation that we can write. Now, tell me one thing. Can I write f of x minus f of c is equal to, can I write f of x minus f of c divided by x minus c and multiplied by x minus c? Can I write? See, these two functions are same. F of x minus f of c, simply I have divided by x minus c, that's why I have multiplied by x minus c. Right? And limit x tends to. Now, this is the simple mathematical statement. F of x minus f of c is equal to f of x minus f of c divided by x minus c and multiplied by x minus c. That I can write simply. Now, take the limit both the sides. Limit x tends to c. Now, limit x tends to c f of x minus f of c is equal to limit x tends to c f of x minus f of c divided by x minus c into limit x tends to c x minus c. Now see what happens here. Now limit x tends to c f of x minus limit x tends to c f of c is equal to limit x tends to c f of x minus f of c divided by x minus c. Limit x tends to c f of x minus f of c upon x minus c is equal to what? I can write f dash c. I can write f dash c. That's why this part becomes f dash of c into. Now here what? Limit x tends to c and x minus c. If I put here x equal to c, this whole term becomes 0. That's why this is equal to 0. Right? It means what? It means what? It means limit f of x tends to c minus limit f of c x tends to c is equal to 0. It means what? It implies that limit f of x tends to c is equal to, can I write now, limit f of c x tends to c is simply what? F of c. See, now this is the proof. That means limit f of x tends to c, that is what? Continuity. This is the condition for the continuity. Limit f of x tends to c is equal to f of c. That means now this function is continuous also. Because we know that we can prove that function is continuous if its left hand limit, right hand limit exists. That means limit of f of x tends to c is equal to f of c. Then the given function is continuous also. That's why we have started with what? That the function was differentiable, and we have come to the end, yes, when the function was differentiable, it is also continuous. That's why each and every differentiable function is continuous, right? The function which is differentiable, it must be continuous. This is the concept. Now, the converse, every continuous function is not differentiable. Let us see now. the converse. The converse. Okay, now f of x is equal to mod x. Check the continuity at x equal to 0. Tell me now, f of x is equal to mod x. F of x is equal to mod x means what? If I ask draw the graph of f of x is equal to mod x, you know how to draw the graph. F of x is equal to mod x. If you see the graph, simply we can say yes, this function is continuous, no problem. This function is continuous. I can draw the graph of this function without lifting up my pen. Isn't it? F of x is equal to mod x, you know that f of x is equal to x provided x is greater than or equal to 0 and minus x provided x is less than 0. Write this part, the definition of this mod function we know. Now, this function is continuous. Now tell me and check the differentiability of this function at x equal to 0. Check the differentiability of this function at x equal to 0. And when I asked to check the differentiability of this function, differentiability, I have to check at x is equal to 0. Now, what we will do? We will find out the left hand limit, we will find out the right hand limit. We will find the left hand derivative and right hand derivative. For left hand derivative, we write L f dash of 0, right? And that is equal to what I can write? Limit h tends to 0, f of 0 minus h minus f of 0 upon minus h. This is equal to what? Limit h tends to 0, f of x is equal to mod x. That's the f of 0 minus h is equal to what? 0 minus h minus f of 0 will be simply 0 whole divided by minus h is equal to limit s tends to 0 mod of minus h simply h upon minus h is equal to what? Minus 1. That is the left hand derivative is minus 1. Now right hand derivative, I am checking at 0. This is equal to limit h tends to 0 f of 0 plus h, right, minus f of 0 upon h will write. This is equal to what? Limit h tends to 0 f of 0 plus h is equal to mod of 0 plus h, mod of 0 plus h minus 0 whole divided by h, and that is equal to limit h tends to 0 mod of h is simply h by h is equal to 1. See now, the right hand limit, right hand derivative is 1 and left hand derivative is minus 1. Then now we can conclude that here LHD is not equal to RSD because minus 1 is not equal to 1, and therefore f of x is equal to mod x is not differentiable, is not differentiable at x is equal to 0, but it is continuous at x is equal to 0. I think now we have come to the end of this part of this question. Yes, sometimes this theorem can be asked in the examination also. Yes, give any examples or give the examples of a function which is differentiable but not continuous, or the continuous but not differentiable, or so that each and every differentiable function is continuous, so that you should have there, and we should have the examples. F of x is equal to mod x, if I write f of x is equal to x minus 1, if I write f of x is equal to x minus 2. Of course, these functions are continuous functions, but these functions are not differentiable at all the points. Right? Very good. Now, I'll discuss the next thing, that is called explicit function. Do you have any idea about this explicit functions? Explicit function.
explicit function.
Explicit, explicit. What the meaning of explicit?
The meaning of this explicit is
to state clearly, to state clearly.
Explicit means to state clearly.
See, this is the
English, or this is the ordinary, or you can say that dictionary meaning of the word explicit. Right? That means to state clearly.
That means y is equal to f of x.
See, y is equal to f of x. Right? Or I write y is equal to x square. Y is equal to 3x square. Y is equal to sine x. Y is equal to 3x square plus 2x plus 7. These are the function f of x in terms of f of x.
Y is the dependent variable. X is the independent variable. Y is the dependent variable, x is the independent variable. You can take the any value of x, and accordingly the value of y keeps on changing. If I take the value of x as keep on changing, that's why x is called what? The independent variable, and y is the dependent variable. Y depending on the value of x, right? That's why if I say in my word, in my way, when I go for mathematics and when I am teaching mathematics and when I have to discuss this explicit, then I'll say that explicit means what? We can write separately. Explicit, we can write separately. We can write separately. Here it is in the according to the Oxford dictionary, the meaning is to state clearly. That is called explicit. But in my view, I can say it is, it means I can write separately. That means for the definition, if I ask, and for the definition, if I have to write, I'll write a function. A function, it is a function.
Explicit is a function. It is a function.
It is a function, right? In which the dependent variable,
in which the dependent variable, dependent variable can be,
dependent variable can be expressed, can be expressed,
can be expressed in terms of independent variable.
Then it is a function in which the dependent variable is expressed or can be expressed in terms of independent variable. It is denoted by y is equal to f of x. Here y is what? Dependent variable.
Y is what? Dependent variable. And this is what? Independent variable.
Now here, this word, it is a function in which the dependent variable can be expressed in terms of independent variable. I can write here also, it is a function in which the dependent variable explicitly expressed in terms of independent variable. Here, the the simple form is that y is equal to f of x. Now for the example, in the example if I write here, the example of the explicit function, I can write that if I write y is equal to 3x square, if I write y is equal to 4x square minus 7x plus 8, if I write y is equal to sine x, if I write y is equal to cos 2x, if I write y is equal to e to the power x plus 7. See now, all the here dependent variable y is separately written in terms of x. That's what is called what? Explicit function. That's what is called what? Explicit functions. Even I can write y is equal to cos inverse x plus c. That means the y can be expressed clearly. Y can be expressed clearly in terms of x. That is called explicit variable. That is called explicit variable. Right? Now, the second thing I will talk about that. Implicit. I-M-P-L-I-C-I-T. I-M-P-L-I-C-I-T. Implicit function. Implicit means what? This is just opposite of explicit. Explicit, twisted clearly, and the implicit, not expressed in direct way. Explicit, not stated clearly. Implicit. Implicit means not stated clearly. Not stated clearly. Or not expressed in direct way. Not expressed in direct way. Expressed in direct way. That is called implicit. Together. That means where the dependent variable and independent variable are not expressed clearly. Here the x and y was expressed very much clearly. The terms involving y, the terms involving x are totally separate. Now see, if I am talking about the implicit function, it is a function in which the dependent variable is not expressed in terms of independent variable is called implicit function. The general form, actually we didn't write f of x comma y equal to 0. That means x and y will be together. This is not y is equal to f of x. Now the function is in terms of x and y. Right? That's why what we can say that it is a function in which dependent variable is not expressed in terms of independent variable. Or what I can say? That a function which is not expressed the terms, the dependent variable very clearly or very separately in terms of independent variable, and that is called what? Implicit functions. For example, if I write now very small and simple example, xy is equal to 1. If I write now sine xy plus x square is equal to 1 or minus 1 equal to 0. Or if I write x square plus y square minus 1 equal to 0. If I write sine xy plus cos x square y plus 7 equal to 0. Now here what we find that here x and y are not stated clearly. The dependent variable and independent variable are not separated clearly. And that's why it is called what? Implicit function. That's why it is called what? Implicit functions. By the way, we can convert any implicit function into the explicit functions also. Yes or no? Yes, we can do it. Let us see now. If I ask you, what is the equation of circle? What is the equation of circle? Having center at 0, 0 and radius 1. Anybody? For I think we have learned class 11th. Right? See, x square plus y square is equal to 1, or I can write x square plus y square minus 1 equal to 0. This is the example of implicit function or explicit function. This is the example of implicit function. Here, y square plus x square, or x square plus y square minus 1 equal to 0. Can I write now? Y square is equal to 1 minus x square. Can I write? Now, can I write y is equal to under root 1 minus x square? Here, plus minus sign. Now, see what happened. Now, this becomes what? Explicit. This is what? Implicit. That's why any function, which is whether it is implicit or explicit, in both the way, we can express it and we can write one function another function. Why I am discussing this? Because these are the functions where we have to have the differentiate also. Suppose I ask you to differentiate xy is equal to 1. Differentiate xy is equal to 1. X into y is equal to 1. I can write y is equal to 1 upon x. Right? This is equal to x to the power minus 1. So now y is equal to x to the power minus 1. Differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. What I will get? Dy by dx is equal to d by dx of x to the power minus 1. X to the power minus 1. This is equal to what? Minus 1 into x to the power minus 1 into minus 1. What I will get now? Minus 1 upon x to the power 2, can I write? Minus 1 upon x square. Dy by dx is minus 1 upon x square. Right? Let us see now. Xy is equal to 1. Xy is equal to now 1. Now I want make it separate. Right? This was the example of implicit functions which we have converted into explicit functions, and then I have differentiated. Here, let it be in terms of implicit function, and now I am going to differentiate it. Now here x and y. Here x and y will be considered as two terms. As two terms. That is product of two terms, x and y. But now you know that x into differentiation of y plus y into differentiation of x is equal to differentiation of 1. Yes or no? X differentiation of second term plus y, that is the second term, and differentiation of first term is equal to differentiation of 1. Now what I will get? X into differentiation of y with respect to x, and write dy by dx, plus y into differentiation of x with respect to x, will have 1, is equal to differentiation of this 1 constant 0, and therefore what I will get? X into dy by dx plus y equal to 0. Therefore, can I write now x into dy by dx is equal to minus y, and therefore dy by dx is equal to minus y upon x. Minus y upon x. Now tell me here, minus y upon x, and here the answer is what? Minus 1 by x square. Both the answers are not same. Both the answers are not same. But we say that yes, it is same. It is same or not? Tell me now. Minus y upon x. Minus y upon x. Can I write minus y 1 by x, and the value of y is how much? Y is how much? 1 upon x. 1 upon x. Ultimately, the answer is same. But here, the answer seems different. That's why it means what? Maybe the answer of the differentiations will vary if we apply the different formula. Please don't get confused with this, whether it is implicit function or explicit, in both the way we can go for the differentiation. Thank you very much. And I hope that in the next lesson we will discuss about the differentiation of the function, which are whether it is implicit functions or explicit functions. But before that, I will discuss the differentiability of the inverse functions also. And for that, I will just tell you one thing. Please go through the concept of the inverse functions, which we have done in last to last class regarding the definition of the inverse functions. Thank you very much for today. बंद हो गया आज वाला, अभी चल रहा है वो।